Welcome back everyone, it's time for more chemistry. This video will focus on magnesium, which is an often overlooked ion in our reef tanks. Reef hobbyists interested mainly in stony corals tend to tunnel vision in on calcium and alkalinity. On one hand, that makes some sense because coral skeletons are primarily made of calcium carbonate. A hobbyist needs to make sure that those two ions are bioavailable because corals take in calcium ions and carbonate ions to grow. On the other hand, it's an incomplete view of what's happening in our water, and keeping those levels can be challenging despite our best efforts. Here is where testing for magnesium can help. So what is the big deal with magnesium? First off, it's the third most abundant ion in salt water, the two most abundant ions being sodium and chloride, which really should come as no surprise. Magnesium is typically measured in parts per million. Parts per million, however, is a slightly deceptive sounding unit of measurement. It's a mass ratio rather than the count of the ions in solution. So for example, magnesium represents 1300 parts per million, while calcium is around 425 parts per million. Based on these numbers, one might assume that magnesium is three times more abundant than calcium. But in reality, it's actually a lot more. Parts per million takes into account the mass of the ions, and it just so happens that calcium is significantly heavier than magnesium. When you compensate for the difference in mass, magnesium is actually five times more abundant than calcium in salt water. The sheer abundance of magnesium is significant because, like calcium, magnesium ions carry two positive charges in solution. As such, the two ions behave similarly and are utilized by our coral inhabitants in like ways. When stony corals form their skeletons, magnesium is regularly substituted for calcium. When reefers are only testing for calcium and alkalinity, they're essentially blind to this third ion in salt water doing a lot of work behind the scenes. Magnesium provides buffering capacity by bonding with carbonate ions. Because magnesium is binding up carbonate, it allows for more carbonate in the water than if magnesium wasn't there. When magnesium levels are appropriately high, it allows for the addition of calcium without the associated drop in alkalinity. So now that we've gone over what magnesium is and why it's important, I'll quickly demonstrate a magnesium test. This particular test kit is made by Sailorford. It's the same brand as the ones I showed in the calcium and alkalinity videos, but I promise I'll show other types of test kits in the future. The test is a basic titration. A good titration will show an immediate change once the buffering capacity is exceeded. Let's start by grabbing our sample. Then we add in our first reagent. The second reagent is a powder, and we want one level teaspoon. And the way that I get a level teaspoon is by scraping off the excess against the container. To mix the sample, I like to give the test tube a little bit of a flick, and the flicking motion creates a small little swirl, and that helps to mix it all in. Finally, we get our 1 mL syringe and we draw up the third reagent, Mg3, here. We want to add this third reagent very slowly into our sample, and this is where the titration essentially begins. I try to give the test tube a flick in between each drop and look out for that color change. We want to see at what point the sample changes color from this pink color to a blue color. And there we have our color change. Let's take a look at where the stopper ended up. It looks like it reads 0.15. 0.15 would be roughly, 1275 parts per million of magnesium. This wraps up our major ion holy trinity of calcium, alkalinity, and magnesium. I'll be doing some more chemistry videos in the future, but not for a little while just yet. In the comments, let me know what sort of chemistry-related topics that you're interested in. Thanks again for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you like what you see. Happy reefing, everyone.